Hello, this is Andrew Ewan. I'm an Inside Application Engineer from Agilent Technologies. Today we'll be going through a demonstration on how to connect hardware up to your 89601B VSA software. When you first turn on your software, this is a sample screen that you might see. It seems like you might be making live measurements, but in all actuality, you're running a simulation mode. You can see that by this simulate measurement notification on the bottom left side of the screen. So let's get started. First thing that we want to do is to make sure that our hardware is connected in the Agilent Connection Expert before the VSA software had started. In this example, I have already established a connection with an N9020A MXA analyzer. You can see that I'm connected through the host name. For more information and detailed instructions on how to get your instruments connected properly in the Agilent Connection Expert, please check out our Connectivity in IO Libraries demo video. So now that we've already established that this connection is good, we can now go back to the VSA software and try to establish a connection. To do that, we'll click Utilities here at the top, then Hardware, then Discovered Instruments. And in this list, you'll see that we have found our Agilent MXA signal analyzer successfully. Now, in the situation where, let's say, we want to add a new hardware into the Agilent Connection Expert, we can refresh this list here and rediscover the instrument. But before we do that, we need to make sure that the hardware is connected properly in the Agilent Connection Expert. So to do that, I'll quickly show you how I will connect to an analyzer that I already have on our network. To do that, I will right-click LAN interface, click Add Instrument, click Add Address, and I'll just use the IP address that the instrument is already assigned to. Test the connection, make sure it's there. Do an identification query to confirm. Click OK. And now that I've seen that it has the screen check mark here, I can go back to the VSA software. I'll go to that same hardware menu under Discovered Instruments and click this green icon here. What this will do is it'll go back over to the interface bus and check to see any new hardware that it needs to rediscover. So here you'll see that this new PSA analyzer that I've just added has now appeared. So once these hardware has been discovered, we now need to go back to the Configurations tab, click this green icon. Note that there are several entries here under the Analyzer menu. Here, the PSA analyzer is the analyzer that I just added the second time. The X-Series analyzer is the analyzer that I was already connected to. So let's go ahead and establish a connection to that analyzer. What I do is click the title here under the analyzer header, click this right arrow, and you'll see that a new drop-down menu has appeared in this list. If there were multiple X-Series analyzers, there would be several entries in this list that I could select from. In this situation, I'm only connected to one MXA analyzer, so there's only one option for me to select. This one looks good, so I'll go ahead and change the name of the analyzer to something I can remember. Let's change it to MXA for now. Click OK, and click OK. Now you'll see that a new analyzer configuration has appeared. MXA here is what we had just called it, and I can confirm that this is the same address that I have set for in the Agilent Connection Expert. Now, we still have not yet made a connection to the analyzer. If you notice, there is another drop-down menu here, which shows a list of all the different configurations that we've set up. So Analyzer 1 is the default analyzer for a simulation mode, and the MXA is the one that I just set up. So in this situation, let's say I wanted to add that second analyzer that we connected to the second time around. I can go through the same process by clicking this green icon. This time I'll select PSA series spectrum analyzer, click the same right arrow. Again, the same drop-down menu appears. Since there's only one PSA analyzer I'm connected to, there's only one option for me to select. I'll go ahead and change the name of the analyzer to PSA. And now you can see that there is another entry here under the analyzer configurations. So let's say we're set here with the configurations and we want to establish a connection to the MXA. All I have to do is click this drop-down menu, click MXA, and now you can see that it's acquiring the MXA. Once it's finished establishing a connection, you can confirm the connection by going into a new menu, which we will see in a moment. And now our instrument is connected. We can confirm this by going to Input, Data From, and note that we're actually selected to Hardware as opposed to Recording, and also it does not say Simulate at the bottom. Congratulations, you are now connected to your hardware. If you have any difficulties getting through any of this process, feel free to call in to reach the Technical Contact Center, and we would be happy to help you.